You know, human genome science is in a position that so many biotechs want to be in. They've got their drug to the market. And now, Tom, how do you transition from being a research-based biotech to a commercial company that's selling a product and has expectations for earnings and everything else?
Well, Shannon, we've been working on this transition for some years. We had a vision to be a fully commercial biotech company for as long as I've been with the company, 6.5 years. And we're very fortunate now with Benlysta, the first new drug approved for lupus in more than 50 years, to have the realization. So it's exciting times. We've got a sales force in place. We've got a company that I think understands its mission and its objectives, and we're out there having very good conversations with physicians and insurers about Benlysta and what it can mean for patients and the sorts of patients that ought to be on this drug.
And now you see your company going forward not just as a science and R&D, but as a commercial company. Is that how you envision the future of your company?
Science-based, focused on specialty markets and disease states that really make a difference where there are severe unmet medical needs. But yeah, I think we see Benlysta as a growth vehicle for our company for many years to come, but beyond that, other things as well.
And do you see yourself continuing as a freestanding company? I mean, you have what everyone wants, a potential blockbuster on the market. Can you carry on as an independent company?
Well, we're certainly building the company to be independent. We're a public company, so one never knows what happens in the future, but we're certainly, it's our vision to be an independent company. We think we can best serve patients and shareholders in that way. And that's the path we're on.
So are you looking to do acquisitions then yourself? Are you out there as a buyer rather than a seller?
Well, our first priority right now is to make sure we fully commercialize Benlysta around the world. U.S. approval in March, European approval we expect probably early in the third quarter, and other countries will come online. That's a very, very big, tall order and will consume us for many years to come. But we're also investing in Benlysta to be able to realize the full therapeutic and commercial potential of the drug in other areas. And then, yes, thirdly, selectively adding to our product pipeline where we see opportunities to do that.
And how big a seller do you think this drug could be, sales-wise?
Well, I think estimates are all over the map. We're saying the drug is very likely to be a blockbuster, which in our definition is $1 billion and up in sales. Right now, our focus is not on forecasting its sales, but to make it sure we're serving
patients. I'm going to have to cut you off there. We'll be right back after the break with... And Tom, I want to talk to you a bit about price here, a difficult subject in biotech. You have the first lupus drug approved in more than 50 years, but it costs about $35,000 a year, if I'm correct on that one. How do you determine your price, and how do you think biotech companies should be setting price forward, especially with a lot of criticism about the price of drugs?
Yeah. Well, in our case, I can tell you, we wanted to be both fair to investors that have been investing in the development of Benlysta for now 15 years. The drug has cost billions of dollars to invest. And we and our partner, GlaxoSmithKline, set a price that we felt would be fair and also recognize our primary objective, which is to make sure that any patient that needs this drug can have access to it. So in addition to the price we set, we offer a very competitive and aggressive patient assistance program to help everybody that needs the drug get it. So it's a challenge with the difficult financial markets that we have to set a price that meets both of the objectives. But I can tell you, first priority is making sure that patients have access to the drug.
But for the U.S. government, who pays for a lot of these drugs through their Medicaid program, are you expecting more pressure to lower the prices from the government, from insurers? Is this going to be a challenge going forward?
Well, I can tell you, one of the messages that we're talking about here at Bio, where 15,000 of our industry colleagues are here, and academicians and scientists, is price of pharmaceuticals is in the range of 12% to 14% of the total healthcare dollar. We feel very much as an industry that we have some of the breakthrough medications now that can allow us to help the industry, help the entire healthcare system save other parts of the other 87% of the healthcare dollar.
All right.
Lower hospitalization, ability of patients to live better lives. So the leverage of the pharmaceutical can make a big difference in many cases.
Well, Tom, thank you very much. Very
thank
good
you
point
very
you raised
much.
There.